Hello everyone, myself Narendra Paliwal. Now we'll be going for fourth part of the project management techniques, which comes under project planning in construction management, chapter 2. This is PERT. What is PERT? Full form of the PERT is Project Evaluation Review Technique. In the critical path method, the time estimates are assumed to be known with certainty in certain projects like research and development. New product introduction, it is difficult to estimate the time of various activities. Like for an example, if you are constructing a mobile phone or you are making a mobile phone and you have, like recently Samsung has introduced a folding phone. So this is the new type of phone. So it will comes under the research and development, and we will use the for management techniques, we will use the PERT technique here. So, hence the PERT is used in such projects with a probabilistic method using three time estimate for an activity rather than a single estimate. Here in the figure you can see, one more thing you have to remember, the PERT is based on the beta curve. We have drawn this curve from probability. This one is the optimistic time, most likely time, expected time is here, and pessimistic time. So what is optimistic time? That is, it is represented by T0 or T0. It is the shortest time taken to complete the activity. It means that if everything goes well, then there is more chance of completing the activity within this time. Most likely time, it is represented by TM. It is the normal time taken to complete an activity if activities were frequently repeated under the same condition. It is represented by TM here. Last one is the TP, that is pessimistic time. It is the longest time that an activity would take to complete. It is the worst time estimate that an activity would take if it is unexpected problems are faced. All the construction activities may or may not face this, but this time is very useful for them because in construction there are lots of uncertainties, so we cannot take into account. So this time is useful for the construction activities. Taking all this time estimate into consideration, the expected time of an activity can be calculated by this formula, that is T0 plus 4TM plus TP divided by 6 will give the time estimate, that is the average or mean value of activity duration. The variance of an activity is given by the formula sigma square. Here the square, please note down here, most of the student do this mistake. Sigma square is TP minus T0 by 6 whole square. It is not sigma, it is sigma square. So for calculation of the sigma, you have to take under root of TP minus T0 divided by 6 whole square. It is not the square of TP minus T0, it is TP minus T0 divided by 6 to the whole square. Probability of the project duration is called Z. Formula given is TS minus TE, TE as you have calculated the estimated time, divided by under root of sigma square, summation of sigma square in critical path. What you have to do here is the only calculate those of summation of sigma square, that is the variance only of those activities which are coming under the critical path. The probability of completing the projected within the scheduled time or the contracted time may be obtained by using the standard normal deviate, where T is the expected time of the project completion time. And the probability of completing the project within the scheduled time is from this formula we can calculate, and the value which are obtained from normal tables. What is the advantages of PERT? Advantages of PERT are, it is expected project completion time, probability of completion before a specified date, the critical path activity, the direct impact on the completion time, activities that have slack time and that can lend resources to critical path activities, activities start and end dates. There are some limitations also. PERT formula required too much work because there are three times of estimate. So the network chart tend to be very large and unwieldy, very large and very hard to move. Calculating the time estimate is very complex for all activities. The updating the project time is consuming and require high cost. Emphasis is laid on the time factors and cost factors are neglected here. So these are the limitations of PERT. Here one example is given. In an R&D project has a list of the tasks to be performed whose time estimates are given in the table. T0, TM and TP in days are given. Activity is given. Activity name is given. First, we have to calculate the time estimate. So for the time estimate, T0 plus TM plus 4 TM plus 4 TM plus TP divided by 6. So for like activity, any activity you can consider, like for this activity 1 to 2, we will take T0 is 4 plus 4 into 6 plus 8 divided by 6, you will write. So T is 6. Now for calculation of sigma square, this will be TP minus T0 divided by 6 to the whole square. So 8 minus 4 divided by 6 to the whole square will come out 0.4. So similarly, we will calculate for each activity. Second step, draw the network diagram. We have already drawn the network diagram here. First, this will represent TE and this one will be TL. So 0 plus 6, 6. 6 plus 2, 8 here. 8 or from here, so 0 plus 4 is 4. 4 plus 8 is 12. 12 plus 4 is 16. Like this way, we will calculate all the TE and TL. So calculate the time earliest and the time latest for all the activities, and from the given diagram we can see that this path is the critical path, that is 1 to 4, 4 to 6 and 6 to 7. The probability of completing the project within the 19 days, like here the time duration given is 22 days. Here the time duration given is 22 days. Here one node I have missed, that is 14. Yet this is 22 and this is also 22. So the T will is here is 22 days. So what we have take, we will just, it is a trial and error. So probability of completion that project time within 19 days, as our critical path is 22 days, but if we want to complete it in 19 days, so what is our probability? We can calculate by this formula, Ts minus T divided by under root of summation of sigma in critical path. So we have taken the critical path of 2.77, 0.44, 1.77, 19 minus 22, minus 3 by root 5, that is minus 1.3416. And from the normal table, we will calculate the value of Z of 1.346, so it comes under 0.4099, and we have calculated this 0.5 minus 0.4999, so this will come under 9.01%. So probability is very much less, because thus the probability of completion the R&D project is 19 days is 9.01%, only 9.01%. Since the probability of completion the project in 19 days is less than 20%, in the question we find the probability of completing, so we have to increase the day. So let's try another example of, for like, as T is given 22 days, what we have taken 19, we cannot do this. So for another we will take 24 days, 2 days forward. So for the 24 days we will calculate, similarly follow the same similar procedure, that is 24 minus 22 minus under root of 5, so 0.8944 days. From the normal table we calculate this value, and 0.5 plus this we calculate 81.33%. For the, so the completion of project in 24 days, the probability here is 81.33%, while in the 19 days it was only 9%. Thank you everyone.